Hello and welcome back to the channel. So this lecture is all about some practice exercise for you to get more familiarity with MapReduce and how it works. So in the previous lecture, we have ran our first MapReduce program where we have downloaded the required file in our sandbox and we have executed it and we have gotten the output as the number of ratings given by each users from our ratings.data file. So this lecture, I'm going to give you some challenges so that you will get more familiar with the MapReduce functionality. So without further ado, let's get into it. So our first task is to count all the user given ratings for each movie in our dataset, which is nothing but a ratings.data file. So here, all you have to do is to change only one thing in the mapper function. So I hope you remember our previous example where we have dealt with the ratings only, but we don't care about ratings now. We have to care about movie IDs and you have to count how many times that movie occurred in our dataset. So just start with this and make sure you can do it. And if you have any difficulties, you can provide your doubts in the below comment box. So since it will be a very simple change, you can use the Nano editor to just edit our existing Python script. So this will be a very simple task. So just hit pause and go and execute your first task. So I hope you completed the first task. So your second task is you have to sort the movies by their number of ratings. So here what you are doing is sorting out the movies as per their popularity and how many times it occurred in the dataset. So the simple strategy would be, first thing you have to use the mapper function to map the movie ID to 1. So it will be a key value pair in which the movie ID will be the key and 1 will be the value. Then the second phase will be the reducer, where the output will be the count of rating, where we'll use aggregation functions such as sum, and the value will be the movie ID. So here we are reversing the key values. So first the key was movie ID and the value was 1, but here the output of the reducer will be the key will be sum of ratings and the value will be movie ID. But wait a minute, we haven't sorted it out yet. So for sorting out, we have to send this to the second reducer. So we can end up with the things sorted out by the rating count. So it's a little bit head scratcher as you have to add one more reducer function to it. So if you have basic Python knowledge, you can easily crack it. Or if not, just follow along with me for the solution of this problem. Okay, so now we will go to our first task. So for that, just boot your cluster and log into your terminal using PuTTY. And the password is maria_dev. So here we already have our Python file, so we will just make use of it. So here is our file, so we'll just use it, the Nano editor, to edit the file movieratings.py. Yeah, so this could be the small change. So here what we're doing is we are mapping the rating with 1. But instead of rating, we don't have to care about rating now. So we just have to change it to the movie ID. That's it. So just change it for movie ID. So what it does is the mapper function will map each movie ID with the value 1. So the movie ID will be key and the value is 1. And then we are doing aggregation on the values so that we'll get to know the movie ID and how many times it occurs in our dataset. It was a very simple change. So I hope you are able to do it. So just hit Ctrl O to write down your results. Hit Enter and Ctrl X. So that's it. You have made your changes. So we will just run it locally by giving like Python movie ratings.py. And our data file, which is ratings.data. That's it. So here you can see, what we're getting here is the movie ID and how many times it's occurring in our dataset. But here you can see, like, it is not sorted according to the values and it is just giving us the mixed results. So that will be our second task, to sort it out as per the popularity of the movie. So it will give us the movie ID and the most popular movie in our dataset. So this is the solution for our second task. So let me just walk you through it step by step. So the first thing first, we are importing the MRJob package, and we are importing MRJob and MRState from that. And we have our class ratings breakdown, and we have our mapper function. So the mapper function will map each movie ID to the one value as we have discussed. So the output of the mapper function will be the key, which is movie ID, and the value is 1. And the next, we have our reducer function. So what it does is, it will take the key value as movie ID and 1. Now it will reverse it. So here we are using the sum aggregation function to count the occurrence of each movie ID in our dataset. So that will be the key. And we are using 0fill, which is zfill, to fill the zeros from left up to the 5 digits to make it more representable. And we are converting it into string. And the key will be nothing but the movie. So here we have reversed the key values to values key. And for sorting out, we have the another reducer function, which will automatically sort it out the values for us, and we just have to iterate it for each of the movies in our dataset. So that's why we are using for loop here, and the last piece of code we'll just use for running our script. So if this solution matches yours, then congratulations, you have got all the things you need to run your own MapReduce job on the Hadoop cluster. If not, don't worry. I know this will be difficult for you if you're not from the programming background, or else this MapReduce is pretty new to you. So just follow along and that will be enough. So to make your life simpler, I have just uploaded the solution as TopMovies.py in the Hadoop repository. So first we will just download that file in our sandbox, and then we can execute it either locally or on the Hadoop cluster. So to download that file, just give like wget https://raw.github-usercontent.com/my-username, which is ashaypatil11/the-repository-is-hadoop/the-branch, which is main/our-python-script. So it is topmovies.py. So just hit pause and check for the typing errors. It looks good to me, so hit enter. And that's it. The file has been downloaded. So let's execute this file on our ratings.data file. So we'll just run it locally to simplify the things. So just give like python topmovies.py and give the data file, which is ratings.data. Hit enter. That's it. Our file is running now. And here you can see, this is the output. So because of the zero fills, it's the value has been filled with zeros from the left up to 5 digits. So from this, you'll get to know this movie ID 739 has been occurred 164 times in our dataset. So this is the most popular movie. So what is the movie name? That is still a mystery. And we will find it out in our upcoming tutorials, where we'll deal with Hadoop tool to submit SQL queries on the data stored in HDFS. So this is pretty much it. So I hope you got a clear understanding now. So how we can work with the data by writing the mapper function and reducer function, so that we can do all sort of operations on our data file. So I hope you have tried to solve these two tasks which we discuss in today's lecture. So if you are successfully completed both the tasks, then congratulations. You have understood the whole concept of MapReduce and how it works under the hood. But if not, don't worry. It could be quite difficult at the start. So just follow along and that will be more than enough. And if you have any doubts, you can put your comments in the comment box below. So I hope you like this lecture. So please subscribe to our channel and also ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on our social media that I have linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.